So there's been a great deal of interest in this new technology referred to as iPS cells. iPS refers to induced pluripotential stem cell. Pluripotential means it's capable of producing many different types of tissues. The reason why it's induced is that what you do is you take a skin biopsy specimen. So just take a piece of your skin and actually then remove the fibroblasts, for example, which is a cell type that you find very frequently in this skin. You can get this from anybody. And then by genetic modification, where you insert four genes, classically, although that's being modified, but you inject four specific genes, and you can make this into an embryonic-like cell. It looks almost like it's from the embryo, in that it's capable of becoming every tissue of the body we think. You inject these into animals, and you find that these cells cause teratomas. Now, the reason why I tell you that is that this is the fear with embryonic stem cells, that if we use them clinically, if we use the stem cell clinically, those cells will start producing a form of cancer. It's important for us to know that they are able to do this because it means it's embryonic-like. On the other hand, it is also the shortcoming of embryonic stem cells as how do you make a tissue and take advantages of the embryonic stem cell and its capacity to make tissues without the risk of cancer production. So this is now the definition of what an iPS is, by being able to act like an embryonic stem cell, capable of producing liver, lung, heart, bone marrow. And we're now trying to harness the power of taking a piece of skin, putting in those four genes, making them to embryonic stem cells, and then in turn, in the future, make the various tissues that we like. But this therapy is still many years away. It's a future direction. It's a powerful technology. The reason why we might want to do this is that I can take you with a specific disease, for example, epidermolysis bullosa, that skin disease, and I can make your skin, and I can even correct it by correcting the genetic defect, which is the reason why you got the disease to begin with. And I can make a skin therapy that is specific to you because it's from your skin. So I can do this for other diseases as well. So for example, if you have diabetes, or if you have a genetic disease called Fanconi anemia, which is a defect that causes bone marrow failure, or you have EB, the skin disease, these are all due to some type of genetic defect. What I can do is I can make the iPS cells from a skin biopsy derived from any individual patient, make them into an embryonic-like cell, in turn then make the tissue that you want. So for diabetes, you'd make islet cells. For Fanconi anemia, you would make bone marrow cells. For EB, you make skin cells. And I genetically correct them so they no longer create the disease. But the benefit of this is that they're from your own body. I'm making a cell that's specific to you. I can't use for anybody else, only for you. And the benefit is I don't have to worry about the immune system rejecting those stem cells. Right now, when we talk about stem cell therapies, the only way this can work is if I take those stem cells from somebody else that's closely matched with you. But the reason why this therapy is risky is because of the fact that I have to trick the immune system, and by doing that, I incur many, many more risks to the patient. The stem cell will go into the patient and can work and make the skin or correct the bone marrow. But by then tricking that immune system, I also increase your risk of infection or other major life-threatening side effects. iPS cells may be a way of the future that will obviate those risks, making these stem cell therapies in the future a much safer approach.